Walt Disney Company is looking at a horizon fraught with a proxy war. Nelson Peltz is coming after them. No, he may not win board seats this year, but he and Jay Rasulo are ready to wage war. Joining them, Ike Perlmutter, and who knows, maybe even Elon Musk. So what is Bob Iger to do? How can he steady the ship when the Disney Company is looking at possibly the worst year financially in modern history for the company? Well, they just might get a win from the NFL. Hello, folks. Welcome back to the channel where we are changing Hollywood one video at a time, simply by telling the truth, keeping you ahead of the culture curve. It's what we do here each and every day, and it's a joy to do so. Today, we're talking about something that takes us a little bit outside of our typical and normal domain. But just like when politics enters into entertainment, so too do we cover when sports enters into entertainment. And sports has very, very strongly entered into what we must discuss today, specifically the National Football League, which may be getting ready to purchase a significant portion of ESPN. There's a lot to cover here. It has massive ramifications for the financial outcome of the Walt Disney Company, and it could be the thing that Bob Iger pins as a reason for him to continue to win against those who would like to toss him out of the doors of the House of Mouse. Folks, we've got a panel. It's fantastic. Let's dive into the conversation right now. This could be the thing that Disney is going to lean upon for their earnings call, so that's why it matters so much. We've got this out of the dailycaller.com. NFL and ESPN on verge of massive deal that would give the league a stake into the four-letter network report. Now, as we get into this story, folks, please notice that we have an exclusive on the backside of this story that's not included in the article or any other article out there that we're ready to bring to you. Here's the story, though, as we have it. This is by Andrew Powell. You know how I always say the NFL is a modern-day Rome with no end in sight? Yep, and it only seems to be ratcheting up at the fact that the NFL is reportedly in talks with ESPN to obtain a stake in the four-letter network. Conversations between the two giants are steamrolling along smoothly, according to Andrew Marchand of the New York Post, with things being so deep into the process that both the NFLPA and team owners have been informed about the potential deal because of revenue-sharing implications. If the deal goes through, it would reportedly see ESPN becoming the new management of the NFL's in-house media division, which is more commonly known as NFL Media. They would run the iconic NFL Red Zone, NFL Network, NFL Plus, and the legendary NFL Films. With ESPN taking over, the NFL would receive equity in the network in exchange. We all know what's going on here. Disney is struggling. Let's pause on that statement. Disney is struggling, and badly at that, and have found themselves a golden ticket. Yeah, I'm a bit concerned due to ESPN's track record over the past decade or so of having horrible television. But with how powerful in particular the NFL is, I think it'll be fine and essentially get the same product. If anything, this is just Mickey Mouse trying to get out of the hole and the league trying to get more Roman-like. I'll say this too to the panel. I think this is a little bit odd because ESPN is actually going into gambling significantly. So how does this work if the NFL then is buying a stake in something that is involved in something that the NFL can't be involved in? It's very bizarre. Being a sports league and having a stake in a massive corporate television network like ESPN, that's crazy. So that's the deal right now, is that the NFL is looking to be completely intertwined with ESPN. That would save Disney's butts for the earnings call. But there's more to this, folks. What we are hearing, this came to us yesterday from a source. This source is connected with parts of Disney that would know this. We'll just stop there because we don't need to out anybody. Right. But we're hearing that the people who work on the parts of the NFL that would be affected by this, apparently they felt blindsided by this, and they were blindsided by it to such a degree that there are allegedly emergency town hall meetings being held with NFL crew members tomorrow to go over some of these concerns and some of the issues at hand. So that exclusive to this channel, breaking nowhere else, you were here and heard it first because of it. The NFL, we are told, having emergency meetings tomorrow with those who feel like they were left out in the dark regarding all of this, and it could greatly, greatly impact their jobs. As we get ready to explain why it could greatly impact their jobs, let's bring on Valiant Renegade, as we promised, joining us now live. And Valiant, welcome to the show. Jonas, could you tell us a little bit about why exactly the folks who work for the NFL might be panicking right now?
Well, because Which reason would you like to go through first?
Let's go with job security first.
ESPN has a in their view a robust production pipeline here, and they will want to take over everything that's going on. If the NFL is handing this off to let's just say it, the largest entertainment company in the world that does sports, Netflix being excluded there. Heaven help them all if Netflix decides to get into sports. Let's just say that. Mm-hmm. NFL media will, if it comes under ESPN, they're going to want to do their ESPN thing. They're going to want to use their own people. This is an organization that is apparently pretty tight-knit. I mean, they ran this Emmy-stealing scheme for quite some time. I would not want to be the people coming in to the Disney Corporation here. Those coming in don't fare well when they enter into the Walt Disney Company. So they will have to bow to the mouse or eventually find their way out.
Well, before we go to Valiant, I want to go to Mexican Iron Man because he's here specifically to talk about this situation. Mike, what do you know about the ESPN and NFL, and why is it a big deal to the industry?
Well, I watch a ton of football. I mean, I watch literally a ton of it. I watch a ton of college football. I spend shockingly as this might be to hear, I certainly spend as much time or more watching football than I do watching YouTube. And I'm on YouTube all the time, as people know, though I am not a YouTuber.
And that you'll be watching the 49ers next week, and I know for sure.
I will for sure be watching that Saturday night. But I am not excited about this announcement. Of all the people to get married and merge together, the NFL and ESPN is a recipe for absolute disaster in sports, disaster in culture, disaster in television, and disaster and chaos in streaming. We just got we are on the heels of an absolute outrage that's occurred by NFL fans globally, which relates to the fact that Peacock was an exclusive streamer for the very first time. Now, whether you're a Chiefs fan or not, mm-hmm. there was a lot of outrage about this game being watched on Peacock. There's a lot of confusion about where to go. I think there are so many reasons why this is a bad idea. Frankly, job security of the people that work there is just one minor issue. Within the NFL, they've had horrific problems in terms of dealing with how they're dealing with race and politics and culture and wokeness. They pulled back from it sort of kind of a little bit. Baseball managed to do it. The NBA didn't. They went full throttle and never came back. I don't think this is a good move for the NFL. I think this is I understand why, from an ESPN standpoint, they want to get their grubby hands on anything and everything they can. Because at the same time that this deal may or may not be happening, or whatever the terms are, they've got a ticking time bomb with the NBA licensing fees right around the corner. Coming up, and I'm sure I've heard Valiant talk about that. I'm going to defer to him on that subject to lay the context. But the backdrop of this, from the fandom perspective, this is a horrific idea. I think it's bad for broadcasting. It's bad for fans. It's bad for the future. I don't think it's going to bode well. It's going to create what we've already seen with the streaming wars. And what did the streaming wars do? The streaming wars created an absolute chaotic mess of a disaster for everybody. In the pressing search for greed, in the pressing search for whatever they thought were going to be a high stock price, all we're left with is a box office that is underperformed, movies and TV that don't know where to play, when to play to get the most or not, and this, that, or the other. And what we're going to have with this potential deal is we're going to have fandoms confused, divided, and lost in terms of the future direction.
Can I just reemphasize that point? Because everything that the stock market has just struggled with as far as streaming services, they're about to do it again with ESPN DTC. They're going to start on this grind at least one more time. They're going to go back to that struggle of, oh, well, we plan to be at profitability at this point. In fact, I wonder if they're waiting for Disney Plus to get to profitability before they announce this. They announced the struggle here. Valiant, looks like you got something to say there.
This is a very, very complicated issue. And I was going to do a video on this, but I decided y'all were talking about this today. Perfect opportunity. I'm home today because of the weather. Let me come on here and effectively do my video.
By the way, folks, when he says he's here because of the weather, he says they're sub 60 degrees Fahrenheit in,
yes,
in Louisiana. So back down the hatches.
I don't know what icicles are. They're on my car. They're supposed to be in my freezer. What's going on? I'm a kid.
Valiant, just so you know, out here in Hilton Head Island, we're, I've had to put my sweater on. We're down to 58 degrees here.
Yeah, look out, folks.
We were 15 degrees this morning where I am in South Louisiana. That ain't right. So, okay, everybody brings up some great points. We've got to back up. If we want to teach the audience what's going on here, want to explain things, we've got to take a few steps back. So all the comments here have a lot of merit, but I want everybody to understand that the outcome of what this is going to look like is going to be incredibly dependent upon what the final agreement looks like, right? So when this is announced, this issue with ESPN and NFL Network is coming out, we knew for months that something like this or this exact thing was imminent. Bob Iger made it very clear since July of last year when he did his presser with CNBC at the whatever it's called in Idaho, where they go for that thing for the weekend, the media conference, where he announced himself as getting extended for another 2 years. We knew that a partnership with a major league was coming. It was going to be one of two leagues, unequivocally. It was going to be either the NFL or the NBA, or perhaps both. I don't think NBA's
a real loser in this announcement, then, eh?
Well,
are you sure?
The NBA could still get in bed. They could still sell another piece. We don't know how big of a piece of ESPN. Hearst owns 20% of ESPN. 80% is owned by Disney. Disney could peel off, 40%, 39% of ESPN and split it between the NFL and the NBA and still be majority owner and controlling interest in ESPN. Here's what the final contract I think is going to look like. And I want people to imagine for a second, you've got to segregate, I know that's a terrible word in social media, but you've got to segregate the two sides of ESPN and ABC and all the affiliates for that matter under the Disney banner. You've got to look at live sports production, including pregame and postgame panels and wrap-ups on that as one element, and then the average run-of-the-mill, 1 o'clock on a Tuesday afternoon, nobody is watching it unless you're at a Mexican restaurant or something, then it's on TV, like Stephen A. Smith garbage show, okay? That's the other side. Nobody watches Stephen A. Smith, I hate to say it. The biggest thing that ESPN has going for it, hilariously, is the Pat McAfee show, which we all know what's going on with that recently. Here's the deal. Nobody, and to all Disney's credit, specifically to ESPN, nobody, and I mean nobody, has their hand on the pulse, and I'm talking about the men and women, the average men and women working at ESPN in production and the technical side of live sports broadcasting. I'm talking about the camera operators, the producers for NFL games, for NBA games. Those people are unequivocally the best of the best of the best at ESPN, and that is one of the shining places at the Walt Disney Company because they haven't screwed it up yet. Hopefully they never will. But that being said, when we talked earlier this year about how Disney was rumored to be having discussions with Amazon, right? Amazon has a piece of the NFL now with the NFL Thursday night, right? They do that on Amazon Prime. They've been expanding that. That has up to this point been the NBC folks that have been effectively turnkey production of those games, right? Amazon is not, I don't think they have their own crews. They're not doing anything. They're using NBC. They're leveraging NBC for that, like off of the NBC or NFL on NBC Sunday nights. That could effectively become in the next couple of years a Disney, if Disney seals that deal with Amazon. You know, they could also seal a deal on a league partnership with NFL and NBA in similar fashion to bring them in. Jonas, I'm sorry.
Go ahead. So if we can bring a slight amount of history here, what they are intending here is for ESPN to be the marketplace of sports here. They want all sports to go through ESPN. They want NCAA to go through ESPN. They want the NFL. They want you to log into an ESPN app.
They've already got the NCAA.
Let me chime in there. And so what we've seen now for those of us who are longtime sports fans is whereas historically ESPN through its radio stations, through its broadcast channel, ESPN, ESPN2, etc., is going from being a place that we would primarily watch commentating or fandom type stuff and some programming here and there, but we're now it's basically trying to turn it into a streaming delivery service.
Yeah.
And well, let me interject here.
And that's where it might be advantageous to partner with Amazon or Apple or, in this case, Microsoft. With they share board members in common with Microsoft now, and Microsoft has just become the world's largest company by market cap, at least for a little bit here.
The sports broadcasters effectively, in terms of doing this and pushing to streaming, and I'll address the Peacock issue, we're at a point now where, I'll be honest, they almost don't have a choice. But, Pro, I know you wanted to have something to say there.
Well, it's actually a programming issue, but folks out there, we're over 1,200 of you viewing right now, but we don't even have 300 likes yet. Folks, let's make sure we give a megaphone to YouTube and let them know that it's time to share this out to all those folks who might not have ever seen the Pro Show. Let's get to 500 likes if we could. It's not a hard thing to do. 200 of you just click the like button. Use those index fingers for a good purpose. I know that Mike only has about 5 minutes left, so I want to go back to Mike. I'm not trying to skip over culture, just timing issues here. But, Mike, I wanted to get your take on the betting issue here, because if the NFL and ESPN have a wedding, is there any concern on your part that the NFL is then going to be married to something that involves betting on sports? It could get tricky here.
Well, I think that's already happened to some extent, because you had the announcement that happened just a few months ago before the last earnings call, where they're trying to prop up stock value and ESPN is trying to get in on that action. And I'll tell you, the amount of advertising for sports betting across all of these shows and channels is just absolutely crazy. It is watching sports betting on while I'm trying to watch college football or pro football or any of these other things, whether they're live or on the rebroadcast. Watching the sports betting ads is almost like watching, I don't know, when I'm trying to watch any news channels, waiting for pharmaceutical ads to pop and, you know, watching a,
Mike, quick question. Nonstop. Why did the NFL move the Raiders from Oakland to Las Vegas?
To break my heart? Was that the wrong answer?
For sports betting.
No, for sports betting. I know that the answer.
That's it. They're all going that way.
Joke, but yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. It's an explosive market. And, down the road, I'm wondering what they're going to do with baseball. But that's a story for another day.
I mean, for me, this is like putting Ozempic and bariatric surgery ads on The Biggest Loser. It's just kind of gross to me. I know that that's where the market is right now. But, there's a reason that these gambling companies exist. And they're taking a cut and the house wins. And whenever it's gambling, the house always wins.
Mm-hmm. The house always wins. And ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed it. Hot, fresh, and excellent. That is the way we try to keep every one of these videos. If you enjoyed it, consider clicking the like button, share, subscribe. And when you click it, you do stick it to the algorithms. It's the notification bell. Drop a comment down below. Let us know your thoughts. And folks, also tell us this issue of the gambling thing. What do you make of that? Do you think the NFL should be connected with ESPN if ESPN and Disney are now connected with that sort of an activity? It's all getting a little bit risque and blurring the lines. I'm not saying that we're going to have another, the White Sox, Black Sox situation with Major League Baseball back in the 1910s. I'm not saying that's going to happen, but, well, it's getting a little dangerous here, getting a little muddled. Folks, one thing that's not muddled is the thing we say at the end of every video. Wherever you are and whatever you're doing, we mean it. Keep learning, keep growing, and keep having fun.